Young onset Alzheimer's disease is a form of dementia, a form of Alzheimer's disease. The difference is that it's in a group of people that are much younger. So the definition is that you have symptoms before the age of 65. It's caused by the same pathology as you see in the more standard type of Alzheimer's disease. And that involves the brain accumulating abnormal proteins known as plaques of amyloid or tangles of tau protein associated with inflammation, which together create the disease and damage the nerve cells. It's not as rare as people think. It's very badly recognized, but in fact, it's around 5 to 7% of all of Alzheimer's disease. So there's about 40,000 cases in the UK. Diagnosis is made in the same way as we make diagnoses of other types of dementia, including standard Alzheimer's disease. So that would involve going to see a neurologist or a psychiatrist and having an assessment that included taking a history of your problems, examining you, and then a number of investigations involving blood tests, an MRI scan or a scan of your brain. You may have memory tests to see what particular pattern of difficulties you have, and then potentially looking at your cerebrospinal fluid for protein abnormalities, or a PET brain scan looking for changes in the proteins in the brain. Young onset Alzheimer's disease can present in the same way as other forms of Alzheimer's disease, so with a memory problem, rapid forgetting, and the things that we think of when we think of somebody having that sort of difficulty. 32% of people with young onset Alzheimer's disease have something that doesn't involve memory as the way that they come to see someone. So one type of presentation might be that you have a language difficulty. And in that case, you may have difficulty finding your words. You may struggle with fluency and find that you have pauses in your language. And we call this logopenic aphasia or primary progressive aphasia. They're two sets of words for the same thing. And effectively, what they mean is that you have a progressive difficulty with your language. In people with that sort of problem, memory is actually relatively intact. And so you can imagine it's a very different way of presenting to somebody with typical Alzheimer's disease. Another type of presentation is if someone has a behavioral change. And again, this is very badly recognized. It might be that somebody becomes apathetic and much more passive than they usually are, or they may become disinhibited and start to make inappropriate comments or do things that are not within their normal personality. And unfortunately, with that type of presentation, insight is often missing. In other words, that person does not realize what they're doing is different, and they don't recognize that it's wrong. And you can imagine that's incredibly distressing for the family and for the friends of that individual, and very difficult to get them to agree to go and see someone. But the commonest type of presentation for young onset Alzheimer's disease that isn't memory-led is the visual or spatial abnormality. And in that case, people present with all sorts of visual difficulties or difficulties recognizing the space around them. The presentation is called posterior cortical atrophy. And basically, it is what it says. The back of the brain, the posterior parts of the brain in the occipital region, the parietal regions, which are involved in vision and space, start to shrink because they get affected more by the disease. And as a result, people develop different types of symptoms. For example, they may go to the optician on multiple occasions because they think their eyesight is a problem. Or they may start bumping into things in their car. They may notice that on one side they're losing their wing mirror because they keep hitting things and their parking can't happen anymore. They may start to struggle with even sitting down in a chair because they can't navigate their way with their body into that space or going through a door. In Alzheimer's disease in general, our treatments are very limited, and that's the same in young onset Alzheimer's disease. We have symptom treatments only at the moment. Those drugs provide a modest benefit in slowing symptom progression, but they don't change the course of the disease. The evidence we have is that they work as well in young onset Alzheimer's disease as they do in standard Alzheimer's disease. When a diagnosis is made of any type of dementia, and particularly with young onset forms of dementia and young onset Alzheimer's disease, it comes, regardless of expectation, as a massive shock. And people deal with it very differently. My first piece of advice is usually that it's a process that one goes through of adjustment to that diagnosis and working out what happens next, and that that process is supported by the team that you are seeing. You are not on your own, and you are very actively able to take support from that group, whether it's psychological support, whether it's answering clinical questions, whether it's just listening, and that not to try and understand everything all in one go, to just go with the process. It takes as long as it takes to reach a point where you understand what the problems are and you have tools, along with other people supporting you, to adjust to and adapt to and work with those problems and accept them.